Almost time now for a quick break, but before then, here's a quick roundup of all the other tidbits within the showbiz space. Do enjoy.
Burna Boy's Lagos Love That Mini concert, The Show, was meant to be an electrifying start to 2023, as Nigerians turned out massively to watch Afrobeat's biggest export open the year with his flattering catalogue. Lagos Love That Mini, the January 1st, is Burna Boy's Nigerian leg of his global album tour, in which he has sold out arenas across Europe and America. The regular tickets sold for 30,000 naira, while the VIP and VVIP sold for 70,000 and 100,000 naira respectively. There were also platinum tickets that cost between 3 to 10 million naira. Though fans' expectations were high, they were cut short as thousands of fans were left in Lagos' windy Harmattan cold while they awaited Burna Boy's arrival for over 8 hours. The concert was slated for 6 p.m. and it was held at the spacious beach ground of Eco Energy City. The show, which was meant to start by 6 p.m., didn't start until past 10 p.m. when it was opened by an explosive performance by the DJ and the MC. The performance by the DJ ran until past 12 a.m, warming up the crowd and preparing them for the entry of Nigeria's Grammy-winning Afro Star. As at 1 a.m, the DJ stopped playing and fans expected that this indicated Burna Boy's impending arrival. However, things couldn't have been farther from expectation. At 3 a.m, the MC came on stage to announce that Burna Boy was ready to perform and his band needed to set up their instruments, therefore asking the now livid crowd to desist from throwing objects at the stage. He was received by boos and didn't tender an apology for keeping them waiting for over 8 hours. Instead, he stated that he had been around since 9 p.m. and he could have walked away from the concert, if not because he loves his fans and because Sheyi Vibes pleaded with him. Burna Boy didn't fail to remind the thousands of people present that he has watched on while they accused him of murdering someone at Cubana nightclub and also that his mother was a backup dancer for Fela. He concluded by stating that in spite of all these, he still loves them and God will punish whoever doesn't love him. Burna Boy's performance started around 3:30 a.m. and he performed till 4:42 a.m., which was just over an hour. While he performed, thousands of fans began to gradually make their way out of the venue. 1 hour and a few minutes into his performance, Burna Boy delivered his international smash hit Last Last, and the heartbreak anthem brought the show to an end. Award-winning author Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie on Friday, December the 30th, 2022, received an honorary chieftaincy title in her hometown, Aba, in Anambra State. According to the organizers, His Royal Highness Igwe Ellen Eze, Eze Aba, conferred the Odeluwa title on Adichie in recognition of her contributions to the welfare of the Aba community. The Odeluwa title, which means one who writes for the world, will make her the first woman to be conferred the chieftaincy title in the hometown of Aba. With this title, Chimamanda officially continues the legacy of her father, Professor James Woye Adichie, who was until his passing beloved by his community as the Odeluwa Aba, meaning someone who writes for the town. Guests at the event included Labour Party presidential candidate Peter Obi, the Obi Afonisha, Igwe Nnemeka Alfred Achebe, Executive Governor of Anambra State, Professor Chukwumaji Soludo, Executive Governor of Edo State, Godwin Obaseki, among others. This title is the latest in a long list of awards and recognitions the globally celebrated author has received from indigenous and international organizations.
And it's also emotional for me because this is in honor of my parents. I accepted this in honor of my parents because my parents raised me to have this great pride in my hometown, in my culture. And so to be celebrated here today is very moving for me. I'm very happy. I'm filled with joy. And it also makes me want to continue to do well because I think that it's important to my people that I continue to represent them well.
Early in December 2022, Adichie received the Distinguished Whisker Award at the Women in Successful Careers Annual Leadership and Mentoring Conference in Lagos, Nigeria. In October, she became the first African woman to receive the Webb Du Bois Medal, Harvard University's highest honor in the field of African and African-American studies. On October 31, 2022, at the BBC New Broadcasting House in London, Adichie delivered the landmark first BBC Wright Lecture for 2022. The lecture, which debuted on November 30, 2022, is being broadcast on BBC Radio. Marvel actor Jeremy Renner is in critical but stable condition after being injured in an accident while plowing snow, Entertainment magazine Variety reported on Monday, January 2nd. Oscar-nominated Renner, who is 51, has owned a home in Washoe County, Nevada for several years, according to the Reno Gazette Journal. That area in northern Nevada received heavy snowfall on New Year's Eve. The actor has starred in multiple Marvel projects. In addition to being an Avenger, Renner has starred in two Mission Impossible films, as well as Arrival, American Hustle, and 28 Weeks Later. He won Best Actor for the 2008 film The Hurt Locker and has received two Oscar nominations for the crime drama film The Town. He is currently starring in Mayor of Kingstown, which is debuting its second season this month.